Coming up, we complete our journey from taking a pile of photos to this, using Bentley's ContextCapture reality modeling software.
Welcome back. I'm Tom Bentley of Bentley Systems. In the last video, we covered how to use ContextCapture's aero triangulation capabilities to orient or pose the photos around our subject. Now we complete the process. All indications from reviewing the photos and the strong results from aero triangulation suggest that it's a slam dunk we'll get a high quality 3D reality model. But let's see what happens.
All that's left now is to set the reconstruction settings and hand off the project to the ContextCapture engine for the final processing into the high fidelity 3D reality model we've been waiting for. Returning to ContextCapture and our original project from the last video, we pick up at the completed aero triangulation step. Clicking the General tab in the Block 1 AT folder, then the New Construction button, launches the final process. Given the high confidence we have in the final results, we could just click straight through and submit the final reconstruction job to ContextCapture Engine and let it rip. But let's take the time to look around a bit. Clicking on the Spatial Framework tab, we see the 3D aero triangulation view again, but this time displaying a yellow bounding box. The box shows exactly the volume the final 3D model will occupy. For this perfect example, the bounding box is tight to the gear subject. However, there are times when this may not be the case. Maybe some of the background was unintentionally captured, as shown in this inset. No problem. Clicking the Edit Region of Interest tool allows you to slide the bounding box sides to focus ContextCapture on only the part of the capture we want. By rotating the view and clicking, then moving the sides of the bounding box, we can get in quite tight to the intended target of this job. This isn't really needed, but it demonstrates what you can do when you perform your first capture. Everything is looking good so far. We click Submit New Production, and we begin the final phase. We leave the default name as Production 1 and click Next. For our purposes, we use the default 3D mesh, although ContextCapture supports several formats used for a variety of purposes and compatibility with other applications. Click Next. Under Format and Options, we can select one of several industry standard formats. For our final model, we'll stick with the default ContextCapture 3MX format. We click Next. Select the folder where the files that make up the 3D reality model will be created, or in this case, use the default, which is a folder named Production 1 located in the Project folder, and click Submit. Once the Submit button is pressed, the job definition is sent to the ContextCapture engine for final processing. At this point, the real computationally intensive part of the 3D capture process begins. Depending on the power of the computer, a combination of the processor speed, the number of cores and threads, and the computing capacity of the GPU video card, the time it takes to create the model can run from a few minutes to several hours. Upon completion, the final results are ready for review. Clicking on the Production 1 folder in ContextCapture Master, we have the option to view the 3D model directly using the same viewer used earlier to inspect the results with the posed photos. Or we can view the results in Bentley's free Acute 3D Viewer app. Acute 3D gives you the ability to inspect the final model for accuracy and quality. Using the navigation tools, you can move around the reality model with ease. The basic navigation functions are controlled from the toolbar. The home icon resets the view to the default, which is the default view when you open the model. The orbit icon allows you to spin the model using the mouse pointer and left button. Note the orbit is always around the center of the window and not the object. this is not always obvious. A little tip here. The hand or pan icon allows you to move the model around left, right, up, and down. There is a whole list of keyboard, key, and mouse combinations that provide additional navigation control. Way too many to go through in this video. You can find a list of all these shortcuts and other useful information in the user manual available from the help menu. So what's up with the thing that looks like bioluminescent fungus in the middle of our model? Here's the deal. Although we did a pretty good job of shooting the photos of the hole, we didn't quite nail it. Artifacts like this are usually the result of not providing context capture with a complete picture. This results in artifacts like our fungus. You can edit the model in the Context Capture Editor program to remove this and other anomalies. An alternative would be to take additional photos of the hole with more lighting and go through the context capture workflow again. As a first capture, this is pretty good, and we're not going to stress about it. Context Capture Editor and other advanced troubleshooting topics will be covered in another video. Who knows? This model might make a return. So, we've had some fun looking around the new model, but can we be sure this is a real model? A common question people ask. Easy to prove. On the acute 3D toolbar, clicking the texture icon toggles the display of the texture, showing you the actual model underneath that very realistic exterior. Further, clicking on the wireframe icon displays the wireframe of the 3D model. Quite a difference in appearance, isn't it? Toggling the texture on shows us the wireframe overlaying the exterior texture. This begins to show you just how accurate and detailed the model really is as we zoom in. Watch this. You've now experienced the amazing detail in the textures and color of the model. This is no simple scan. It is a true digital representation of the model, capturing the age and essence of the original subject, right down to the wood grain, flaws, and patina of the yellow paint. And remember, this was generated from a bunch of photos taken with just an iPhone. At the start of the series, we described this industrial artifact as lost to time. No longer. With this digital 3D reality model, this gear will be around a long, long time. We hope you enjoyed this beginner series and that it piqued your interest in exploring what context capture can do. If you'd like to try your hand at context capture with the photos we used in this video, a link is provided in the description for the zip file containing the pictures. You can also review the final product we generated, a link to which is provided in the description. If you have questions about what we just covered, please visit the Reality Modeling Forum on Bentley Communities at the link provided in the description below. Be sure to subscribe to our channel to follow along with the rest of this video series. Thanks, and we'll see you next time.